On September 19, 2023, a new Java version will be released. Every four versions, Java releases an LTS version, a long-term support version, a version that will be maintained for at least 8 years. The latest LTS version was Java 17, released on September 2021. From there, every 6 months, they release a new version, until the 21, which is another LTS. In this video, I will show the most important features of Java 21, how to install and use Java 21 in your terminal and in your IDE. Let's start, but first I will just ask you to click on the subscribe button to support my work. I will first use SDKman to install the new version of Java. If you want more info about SDKman, I've already made a video, check the link in the corner. Let's first check all the available versions. As I did the video before the release date of version 21, I only have access to the early access version. But from September 19th, 2023, you will see version 21 here. So I copy the version and let's install this one. I have now installed the latest Java version, but I must configure my laptop to use it by default. Now it's ready. And from Java 9, I can use directly the Java shell from a terminal. Here I can directly write all my Java code. In fact, I will show the first feature of Java 21 here. From the version 15, I can already use text blocks. With the text blocks, I can write and include the new lines inside a single block. But the problem comes when I need to use variables inside the string. Until now, I had to concatenate the strings. This is very frustrating, as many languages already allow to replace variable values inside the strings. But in Java 21, I can do it. The str is the template processor. This means that the variable will be stringified. I also have fmt for number formats and raw for raw strings with special values. But this is an open implementation where I can build my own processor. Let's now configure IntelliJ to work with the latest version. I first open File and Project Structure. In the Project tab, I selected the installed version, which is now detected by IntelliJ. I select the language level, in my case is 20 as the 21 is not already available. And in the SDK tab, I also select the version 21 of Java. I apply, OK. That's a modification. In the settings, I go to build, compiler, and compiler. And I must make sure that the bytecode uses the latest version. I apply, OK. Now I will create a scratch file where I will put all the code. Let's first create an enum class. Enum value with the values 1, 2, and 3. Now I get the value 1. And I create a switch on V in case of 1, system out print line 1, break case 2, the same with 2, and now just the default with 0. The switch was introduced long time ago in Java. In the beginning, it only accepted integers and enumerators. But in Java 14 was introduced the switch expressions. Result 1, 2, and 0. It's an integer. Okay, it now uses the lambda inside each case, and it can even return a value. But with Java 21, now I can even use reference types. Let's create my first class. User, empty. Now, two more classes, which extends the user class. Also empty. Admin and customer. Also extends user class. Now instantiate a user. Let's say an admin. Let's go to the switch. To save the value, switch the user. In case of admin, the variable name A, it returns admin. In case of customer, with a variable name C, it returns customer. In case of null value, it returns null. And the default values, it returns other. First, if the selector matches, the variable is mapped into the given inner variable. But the selector can now be a class type. This way, I avoid having a list of if conditions with the instance of. Let's talk about the records. They were introduced in Java 16. Let's start creating a record. Car with a model field and a brand field. I will instantiate a car, the model S of a Tesla. The records are immutable objects created with a single line. Immutable because once set in the constructor, the field values can't be updated. It throws an error. So, with the records, I tend to create a lot of small classes. Having a lot of small classes can lead to a lot of if conditions with instance of. But in Java 14, there were already an update. Let's move the variable C into a variable O, which is not identified. Now, I write if O is instance of car, I will name it T from Tesla. And I can print system out print line. The model of the car directly. Inside the instance of, I can check against a class method and cast it directly to a variable. I don't need anymore the explicit cast. And now the update from Java 21 with the records. I can not only map the object against a record with a variable name, but I can even get rid of the variable name and use directly the field names. Long time ago was created the executor service to manage the threads. With the executor service, I can append tasks to run in a thread. Executors, new thread. Your task executor. Executors, default thread factory. All this in the executor instance. Let's run it by a try catch, a try with resources. And now I will create an integer string from a range from 0 to 10. And for each, I will submit to the executor a thread sleep duration in seconds, 1 second. And at the end, print finish it. Let's return the I. Okay, this creates 10 threads. On each one, I wait 1 second, then I print finish it. I'm running this on my laptop, which has 12 CPUs. What if I increase the number of 10 to, let's say, 10 millions? out of memory error. I should have expected this error, but let's use now the virtual threads, which again 10 million. It can continue, and it finishes printing all the 10 millions. I didn't wait 10 million seconds, because the execution was run in parallel threads. How is that possible in my 12 CPUs laptop? Thanks to the virtual threads. The virtual threads are no longer bound to the hardware. They are lightweight, consume few resources, and can share the same CPU. They are a lot more efficient. There are more features in Java 21, but those are the ones I like the most: string templates, pattern matching for switch, record patterns, and the virtual threads. I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to click on the like button, subscribe to my channel, and see you soon. Bye!